focus of my research group is understanding the role of gut microbiome in health and disease. Now, over the last 10 to 15 years, with the advent of the DNA sequence technology, we have become aware of just how important the gut microbiome is. We now know that the gut microbiome is important in the maturation of our immune system, but they're also involved in disorders such as development of diabetes, obesity, colon cancer. There's now even association of the microbiome with the brain and some cognitive function. So one of the areas that we're looking at is the importance of the microbiome in resisting colonization by pathogenic bacteria. And the one that we are currently interested in is a bacterium called Clostridium difficile. Now, this causes tens of thousands of infections in the UK. It affects mainly the elderly patients who go to the hospital and where their healthy microbiome is damaged, and that allows the C. difficile pathogens to multiply and cause the disease. So the healthy microbiome is extremely diverse. However, when this homeostasis of the microbiome is damaged, for example, by taking in broad-spectrum antibiotics, which some of the patients receive when they go to the hospital, that causes damage to the healthy microbiome, and that then allows the pathogenic bacteria to proliferate and produce toxins and cause the disease. So having understood the importance of the gut microbiome, we're now trying to exploit the microbiome as medicine. And here we're using several different approaches. So one of them is to replace a damaged microbiome with a healthy one. And this is a procedure called FMT, or faecal microbiota transplant. And it's very effective compared to the treatment by antibiotics in the C. difficile patient, where it's only 30% successful. We have shown that using FMT, we can actually cure more than 90% of the patient in just a single treatment. Of course, the FMT procedure has to be delivered in a clinical setting, and this is done in collaboration with our colleagues in the Norfolk Norwich University Hospital. And together, we are constantly trying to improve and refine the method of delivery so that the whole procedure becomes more efficacious. Of course, the other aspect of the microbiome we're looking at is using the products of the microbiome. So one of those is a product called endolysin, which is derived from phages. So these phages are viruses which only infects certain bacteria. So rather than use an antibiotic which kills the pathogen, but it also damages your commensal or the healthy bacteria, these phages are very specific and will only kill the target organism without causing the collateral damage to your healthy microbiome. So we're using phages, but we're also using a product derived from phage called endolysin. So these endolysin phages normally use to make holes in the bacterial cell wall, but we can actually engineer these proteins to be applied as a medicine and to target the pathogen only. Also within the gut microbiome, you know, we have nearly 100 trillion bacteria and hundreds of species. So there's always a lot of competition. It's almost like a war zone in your gut. And some of the weapons that some of these bacteria use, we can actually exploit. So for example, some bacteria within the gut, they produce antimicrobials called bacteriocins. So we're also trying to use genome mining to discover new bacteriocins that we can then exploit and use as antimicrobial instead of the traditional antibiotics. So this will also have an impact on the AMR, or the antimicrobial resistance problem that we are facing currently. So in essence, we can use specific components of the microbiome such as phage endolysins and antimicrobial peptides. Alternatively, we can use the whole microbiome from a healthy donor and transplant that into a patient to cure disorders such as Clostridium difficile that we are currently doing. But also the microbiome has a huge potential and there is possibility of using FMT to treat other disorders such as ulcerative colitis and diabetes.